Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we're gonna do my June favorites. I asked you guys earlier on Twitter what you wanted to see, if you wanted to see a June favorites video or if you wanted to see how I style a short hair video. And I had a ton of June favorites videos, but don't you worry, everyone that requested the how I style short hair video, that will be up tomorrow. So I'm just gonna jump in because I kind of have a lot of products sitting in front of me. So let's get going. So the first things that I want to talk about are a couple of hair products since I have transitioned into short hair. And the first one is Flip It Over. I have mentioned this product before when I did kind of a shorter hair tutorial. And this stuff is amazing if you have a bob or if you just have shorter length hair in general. I feel though if your hair is kind of to this, almost to your boobs, then this product isn't going to work for you. This is more of a short hair styling product. So this is just a texturizing and finishing spray, and all you want to do with this is shake it up, flip your head over, spray it in your hair, kind of do the scrunching motion, flip it back over, and then you have this great textured looking bob or whatever kind of shorter hair that you're working with. This stuff is amazing, but just keep in mind that a little bit goes a long way. If you get a little too heavy with this product, it will kind of weigh your hair down and make your hair kind of feel a little gross, to be honest. The next one is also from Big Sexy Hair, and this one is called What a Tease, and it's back comb in a bottle. This stuff is no yolk. That's no joke, in case you were wondering. So, okay, don't shake it. It always says don't shake, and I always want to shake the bottle. But all you do is kind of lift your hair where you want extra volume, and then just spray it in here. I'm just gonna let it sit there for a second. And like, look at that. And why are people always trying to call somebody? Hello? 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 Oh. Hello? And then as you can see, it just created a lot of volume right there. And then I just kind of let it set, and then you can move it around and work with it. I'm sorry, I don't have a mirror in front of me, and yes, I am staring at myself in the monitor. But it just gives you a lot of volume to your hair. I'm gonna do the other side since now we're not even. So I just like to lift it up. Oh. And spray in here. Ugh, and then let it sit there for a second. Like, look at that. It is a pretty strong kind of hold, but if you don't want to back comb your hair and you still want lots of volume in it, this stuff is amazing. Just remember, don't shake it. I don't know what happens if you shake it, but it says not to. And these two Big Sexy Hair products I picked up from Ulta. They have tons of Big Sexy Hair products there. The next one I picked up from Ulta as well, and this is from Sally Hershberger, and this is the Supreme Lift Root Spray, and it just says it boosts lifeless locks, and it also is a heat protectant as well. So all it says to do is spray it on towel dried hair, mainly trying to get it on your roots, but obviously you can spray it all over your hair because it is a heat protectant as well. And then it just recommends to get the most amount of volume that you round brush your hair with a big round brush, which will give you tons of volume in general. This is for normal to fine hair, and I did spray this on my hair a couple nights ago, and I just blew dry it as normal, like I didn't round brush it, and I had tons and tons of volume in my hair. So this stuff is pretty amazing, and it doesn't leave any kind of weird residue on your hair, which is a huge thing that I look for when I use products that I'm spraying on my hair wet, is I want my hair to feel like I have nothing in it when it's dry, and some products don't do that, but this little guy does. So again, this is called the Supreme Lift. Okay, next I want to talk about a few skincare products that I have in front of me. Now the first one I want to talk about is the Clarins Lotus Face Treatment Oil. Now I've had this oil for quite some time now, and I haven't really used it because I have a ton of beauty oils in my bathroom, and sometimes I just forget about the other ones, and then I look over at them and they're like, please use me. So I'm like, okay, I'm so sorry. So I've been using this guy for the past couple of weeks, and I've really been enjoying him. At first I didn't want to use him so much because I didn't like how he smelled, but now the smell doesn't bother me as much as it did when I first bought him. I don't know what happened. I don't know if my palette changed or what, but I have really been enjoying this face oil because I feel like when I put it on my face, it absorbs really quickly into my skin, and it doesn't leave me with like this greasy film that some other beauty oils that I use leave me with. I feel like it really does its job, gets into my skin, absorbs, and really just quenches my skin's thirst. And this is a face oil for oily to combination skin. It's amazing. So the next thing I want to talk about is from Glam Glow, and it is their new mask they just came out with. If you guys are familiar with me and my channel, you know that I love all the Glam Glow masks. except the black one. So I had to pick up the new one when I saw it come out. I did get this the first day that it came out at Sephora, and this is the new Power Mud Dual Cleanse Treatment. So it starts off as a mask on your face to kind of deep clean and cleanse your face from weekly buildup of makeup. But the cool thing about this is it transforms into an oil when you rinse it off your face. So it is a lot easier to rinse off your face. It's really hydrating when you're washing off your face, and the smell of the mask is so good. They are definitely worth the money. They are a little pricey, but like I said, they are worth the money that you spend on them because it really does make a difference in your skin. Love the Glam Glow mask. All right, moving on. I want to talk about two foundations. Ooh, it's getting ready to pour down rain. You hear the thunder?
I'm here by myself.
The first one being the Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk Foundation. I'm pretty sure I've mentioned this before, but I wanted to mention again because I have fallen in love with this foundation like hardcore. When I first got it, I was like, eh, it's alright, whatever. But the thing that makes me love this foundation so much is even though I have oily skin, and people say, you shouldn't wear Luminous Silk if you have oily skin, forget you people, I don't care what you have to say. It makes my skin look so amazing. So how I test a good foundation is sitting in front of these hot lights, and after I'm done filming, I take a good look at my face, and this foundation just sits so well on top of my skin. I absolutely love it. It just makes your skin look so healthy and glowy and luminous, as the name suggests. So I just wanted to give him another shout out because I have been using him like non-stop lately, especially for filming and if doing events and anything like that. Anytime I just want my skin to look really, really good, I reach for this foundation. I have another foundation that I want to mention, and it is the Bare Skin. And I know that I mentioned this in my last favorites, I think, but I wanted to mention it again because a lot of you had recommended to me to apply it using a beauty blender, and I have to say that I love the foundation a million times more than applying it with a brush. Sorry, Bare Minerals, if you're watching this video, but I just think it is so amazing with a beauty blender, and I don't use half the amount of product that I do with the brush. So all that I do is shake it up, pop a couple drops on the back of my hand, tap my finger in it, tap it all over my face, and then blend it out with the beauty blender. And it seems as though it sits better on my face and it wears better on my face than it does if I was applying it with the brush in the buffing motion. It is way quicker and I just love it. And I love this foundation because you can wear it with absolutely nothing else on and you don't look weird as some foundations. If you know what I'm talking about, if you wear makeup a lot and if you just put foundation on your face, you kind of look like a weirdo without anything else on it. This foundation does not do that to you because it has a brightening serum in it, so it just makes your skin look really healthy, really glowy, and I absolutely love, love, love it with the beauty blender. So thanks to all my lovely subbies who recommended that to me. It works phenomenal. Since we're talking about foundations, I do want to mention the Million Dollar Tan Shade Upgrade Extreme. This is a dark foundation booster, which is really great in the summertime months if you don't want to go out and buy all new foundations, or if you're someone like me and sometimes you're really tan and sometimes you're really not tan. This is amazing. So all you do with this is you just mix a few pumps of this into whatever foundation color you're working with, and it's going to just give your foundation that extra boost it needs when you are nice and bronzed and tan. It's amazing and it doesn't clog your pores and it makes your skin look really healthy and dewy as well. So have to give this little guy a shout out. I will be doing an updated kind of tan, how I tan and maintain my tan, because a lot of you guys have asked to see that. So that'll be coming within the next couple of weeks. I want to talk about the concealer combo that I have been super into lately. And first is the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer in the color Custard. And I mix that with the MAC Prep and Prime in Light Boost. And I apply both of these under my eye at the same exact time, and they just work so well together. I find that if I use the Radiant Creamy Concealer by itself, I don't like it really. I feel like it creases under my eyes, but for some reason when I apply it with the MAC Prep and Prime Light Boost, I feel like it's a whole nother world. It just complements each other beautifully, and I feel like it doesn't crease nearly as much as it does when I wear this concealer solo dolo. There's hairs on me and I don't like it. Next, I want to talk about a few lip products, or maybe more than a few lip products. The first one being my Christian Dior Creme de Rose. I have gone through so many of these. This is like my fourth one, and I only bought him, I don't know, maybe like 3 weeks ago, and he is already biting the bullet. But this is my favorite lip balm. I always have this with me. I keep it by I keep it by my bed at night. I apply it in the morning. I apply it at night. I apply it all through the day. I apply it before I'm doing my makeup. I apply it while I'm doing my makeup. It is just amazing. I love it. It's rose scented and just the texture of it. It's a smoothing, plumping balm. Like I said, I don't know if it plumps your lips, but it definitely smooths them. Two lipsticks. So the first one is from Lorac, and you know I have been obsessed with these Lorac lipsticks. So every time I creep into Ulta, I always find myself other than I'm like, what other colors can I get? So this is a new one that I picked up, and this one is called Girl Next Door. It's the color that I have on my lips. It's just this beautiful pinky peach color, which looks like this. I've just been obsessed with these Lorac lipsticks. They are the Alter Ego lipsticks. They are highly, highly pigmented. Most of the colors are all matte, so you're going to want to apply a gloss over them if you're not really down with the matte lipsticks. They're really long wearing, and I just cannot say enough good things about these lipsticks. I have three, and I'm trying to get them all. The next lipstick is from MAC, and this one is called Syrup, and this is a luster. Mine melted in the car. I don't know if you can see that, but I know the whole world is kind of obsessed with the whole Kylie Jenner lip at the moment, so I've just been trying to find, like, the perfect lip color, and this one's a luster, so as you can see, it has, like, a little bit of a sheen to it. I really, really love this color. It looks great on your lips, and because it has a little bit of that luster in it, you can totally skip the gloss with it and be right out the door. We're from LA Girl, and these are the glazed lip paints. I love them. These are my two favorite out of all of them that I have. So I'm just going to, I guess, put a big old glob on my hand. They're super highly pigmented, as you can see. I'm gonna have to go wipe these off my hand because I can just see them, like, smearing all over my face during the video. So this one is called Blushing, and this one is Baby Doll. I think that they're super comparable to the Too Faced Melted ones, except these have more of a sheen to them and a shine, and the other ones are more of a liquid lipstick, so they're a little bit more matte. But these are super inexpensive, and the quality is really cool. I love how they come. They're really minty, and I need to go wipe them off. And two more that I want to mention are from Bite Beauty. These are so bomb, and the reason that I love these the most is for their smell. They make you want to eat your face. Oh, they're so good. Like, I just want to shove this up my nose and breathe it in all day. Like, that's totally normal, right? So the first one that I have here is called Currant. And then the second one is called Strange Fruit. They are really nicely pigmented, and they don't have that sticky gloss feeling that a lot of glosses have. And again, they just smell so good. And I really like the packaging on them. It feels like a really nice package. They just feel good. And last but not least is just a highlighter, and it is from Becca, and it is called Moonshine, and I love it. I've been wearing it nonstop lately. I'm not super, super into highlighters any other time than the summertime. In the summertime, I don't know, I just like to have some glow happening. But most of the time, I have naturally dewy, oily skin, so I kind of skip highlighters, but I have been wearing them lately. So I wanted to mention this guy. I've had him for a while, and I recently just started breaking into him. This is a beautiful highlight nonetheless. I love using this everywhere. I use it on the brow bone, I use it in the inner corners of my eyes, I use it on my Cupid's bow, and of course on the tops of my cheekbones. So just wanted to give this guy a little mention because I have been super into highlighting lately. So those were all my June favorites. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope I shared with you some things that you want to try. I don't think I have anything else to say. Well, except one thing. You guys remember when I mentioned, oh my god, except one thing. If you guys remember a few videos back when I mentioned that I would be on live TV, I do have my segment linked in the bottom bar for anybody that wants to see, and you don't follow me on social media, and this is the only place that you do follow me, so I will have that listed down below for you guys if you want to check it out. It was a pretty cool experience to be on live TV. I was super, super nervous, but I think I held it all in pretty good. If you guys want to check that out, it's down below. And I will have a new video for you guys tomorrow. Oh, so white girl. So that is it. I don't think I have anything else to say except I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, I will talk to you guys soon. Bye. Oh. Okay, I just gotta fix this hair because it just is annoying me. Guys thought I touched my hair a lot when it was long. Weird resi, and it doesn't resi. For real, swagger jackers. If you don't know what a swagger jacker is, go ahead and Urban Dictionary it. Should I take a selfie? Should you take a selfie? Ooh. heyday. Looks like I've just been through a windstorm. Are really. And now I have these little short hairs.
I'm the baby, gotta love me.
Oy vey, I'm schwitzing in here.